Welcome to my Italian course. Let me guide you to the main points of the first part of the course. In the introduction, which you are watching right now, I would like to present myself, state the targets of this course, and try to instill the reason why you should keep your motivation alive. We are going to know how many native Italian speakers exist around the world and in the European Union. We will look at ways for you to learn according to your needs and expertise. I will propose a method that helps many students to remember new words and that I will implement during the course. Lesson 1 will show you how this method works thanks to a short demonstration followed by the test of the lesson, which will provide explanation. You will support your learning with quizzes in order to fix the new vocabulary into your memory. I will present the result of the questions so you can correct yourself. In the conclusion part, I will discuss about quiz results and ask for your feedback. I'm always interested in improving the quality of my job, as long as the criticism is polite and respectful. Here we are at the beginning of the introduction. I hope you will enjoy the section. Allow me to present myself and my career. My name is Alessandra Grosso. I used to live in Prague, but now I live in Germany. As you can see, I have 2 years' experience in a school with face-to-face Italian lessons, as well as 1 year experience in online teaching. I have achieved my PhD in Logistics in 2014 at the Technical University of Ostrava. If you wish, you can visit my LinkedIn profile and find out much more about me. As you can imagine, I also have experience in teaching technical subjects at the university, which has helped me to develop my teaching skills. The main object of this course is to give a general overview of my language, Italian. After focusing on verbs in the present tense, we will deal with some regular verbs in the present tense. After that, I will introduce you to some irregular verbs, still in the present tense. We will implement everything with example and small talks. And in the end, you will be able to describe obvious, simple issues and actions. So, after all, you will be able to at least start speaking. Be optimistic and keep your motivation high thanks to the following advice. Think about how Italian sounds cool. You can travel the world and show off your language skill, and be always informed about something new. You can get in touch with a rich culture, for example, our poets and writers, Dante, Boccaccio, and many more. It can be fantastic for your career. In fact, one of my students found a job that requires to speak Italian after passing a C1 level exam. There are also many advantages nowadays if you want to learn a new language. Internet can provide you tons of materials. Learning a new language is very good for your health, as it's shown in the linked video. Another good side about learning a new language is all the people you can get in touch with. Think about the 65 million possibilities of having a new friend. Indeed, there are 65 million of native speakers in Italy, 79 million in all Europe. Around 85 million people in the world can speak Italian on a certain level, including not only language students, but also children of immigrants. There are controversial data about the number of Italian native speakers. Further information you can find consulting Wikipedia and the link I have suggested. In this map, we can see the presence of Italian speakers in Europe. In the Vatican City, Italian is one of the official languages, with Latin. In Croatia, Italian is one of the official languages, with Croatian in the eastern part of this nation. In Italy, San Marino is the official language. In Slovenia, Italian is one of the official languages, with Slovenia in many parts of this state. In Switzerland, is one of the official language, with German, French, and Romance. We use the space repetition system in order to fix new concepts into the long memory. It's a good method not only to repeat passively. I'm going to ask you new questions, stimulate you to think and guide you. The course can be very engaging, since I will be available online for suggestions and critics. I can also write in English and German if you need extra support. Another technique which I found very useful is finding a topic you are passionate about and delve into it. It can be geography, history, music, and so on. The acquisition of grammar will be done step by step, since I will utilize a very practical method. As I said before, I will help you with questions and guide you to speak as much as possible. Quiz and exercise will be also provided in the relevant section. Don't be afraid. Congratulations, this is the end of the introduction to my classes. I hope you have enjoyed it.